So by now, you should already be aware about the performance benefits of having an SSD in your system. And if not, you can check on the links around here if I ever add some. This is gonna be awkward in editing. So in most laptops and possibly even in yours would have a hard drive like this. Most of laptops I've seen is pretty much comes with 1 terabyte. So these things store a lot. But the thing is, these things are slow compared to an SSD. And SSDs are essentially like your USB thumb drives, except instead of these puny slow ones, SSDs are much, much faster and much more reliable. On desktops, you're gonna have these hard drives, but you're gonna have a lot more space and you'll be able to slot in an SSD no problem. So you can have a dual drive configuration without having to pull out anything. Just add the SSD, plug it in, and you're good to go. But on a laptop, if you don't have an M.2 or mSATA slot, what we're essentially going to do is take out the DVD drive of your laptop, toss that to the side, and then we're gonna replace it with a caddy where you can put another hard drive in, or in this case, we're gonna put another SSD in the system. And another SSD. We're gonna add an SSD to the system. So of course, first we have the SSD of your choice. Next, you need a hard drive caddy to place the SSD in the optical drive bay. And then finally, this is optional, a enclosure for your now taken out DVD drive. Maybe you might need to use it next time, maybe someone might borrow it. At least now it's an external drive instead of something that just takes up space. We install Macrium Reflect Free, start it up, and then we're gonna be cloning the existing Windows partitions and other system partitions to the SSD. So in my case, it says not sufficient space. What we're gonna do is we're going to give up some space of the C partition. In this case, we're gonna give up right 500 megabytes because that last partition needs around 500 megabytes over here. And then now we can drag that extra partition over there and then make sure that there'll be no unpartitioned space left. click next again, make sure all partitions usually is from as little as 2 to mine as much as 4, and we're gonna start cloning. This is going to take several hours. Mine took 2.5. It might take more for you. After cloning, Windows will now see the new Windows partition or whatever label it's going to be, but to avoid confusion, we're gonna label it Windows SSD. And this step may vary in computers. In the case of Asus and Acer, you wanna jam F2 during startup, and on other computers, you might need to look it up. It varies from computer to computer. If it fails and continues to boot into Windows, simply force off by holding the power button and then try F2 again or whatever key you need to press until you get to the BIOS or UEFI. So once you're in the BIOS, you're going to need to go to boot and change the boot priority from normally the hard disk drive, and now you want to set it to your nice and fancy SSD as boot option 1 in my case. So now you want to install MiniTool Partition Wizard Free, or you can also use Windows built-in disk management software. And then what you're going to do is make sure you delete the old system partitions, whether it's 2 partitions or 4 partitions, but make sure you delete the ones on the hard drive. You're going to tell because it's the one that's bigger. You're going to want to create a new partition. You're going to format that now unallocated space as an extra data partition. So now we're going to give it a name. Mine, I'm going to name it data 2, but you can do whatever name you want to do it. Make sure it's partition NTFS, and then apply, and then okay. And then you wait for this to finish. It may take several minutes. I kind of just made it faster in the video. So again, you might want to take some time, maybe a cup of coffee or something. So once you open this PC or my computer, you're going to see Windows SSD as now C, because Windows now recognize that as a boot drive. You're still going to have your old data partitions, and now you have a brand new data partition. So by the end of all this, you're going to have both an SSD for your Windows and applications. All of those things are now going to be nice and snappy. I can't snap. As well as to keep your old larger capacity hard drive in your computer instead of other guides which tell you to turn to an external drive all exposed and everything. So likers gonna like, haters gonna hate, subscribe so you don't miss any of my future videos, and thank you for watching. I still need some sort of nice outro quote or something. This actually came from our old Windows XP desktop, though that thing has turned into scrap metal now. That thing's ancient. 8.4 gigabytes. I mean, this is also 844 gigs. You can get these things up to 128 gigs now. Dang, look at that. It even has some rubber things on it. Desktop hard drives today don't even have jackets.